So trigonometry Fourier series concept we are discussing. So this set 1 cos omega naught t, cos 2 omega naught t, 3 omega naught t, so on, n omega naught t and so on, infinite number of cos terms and as well as sine terms. So sine n omega naught t, so on. This set forms a closed or complete set of mutually orthogonal functions over the interval t naught to t naught plus t. This concept we are discussing in the previous lecture. So x of t, that means this forms a closed or complete set of mutually orthogonal functions. So any given signal, triangle, rectangle, whatever, generalized representation is any continuous time signal, x of t can be represented as a linear combination of these mutually orthogonal functions. So this is a representation of that linear combination, signal approximation concept using orthogonal functions. So x of t, a naught, a naught can be a 1, a naught can be 0, anything. Later we are going to see how to find these constants. So x of t is a naught, some constant, plus some constant. There we have discussed constants in terms of c1, c2, c naught like that in the first chapter. So here a naught plus a1 into cos omega naught t plus a2 into cos 2 omega naught t, a3 into cos 3 omega naught t, so on. Nth term, an into cos n omega t plus so on. Okay. Next, for sine terms, I am taking constant representation using b variable. So b1 into sine omega naught t plus b2 into sine 2 omega naught t, b3 into sine 3 omega naught t, so on. Bn into sine n omega naught t plus so on. If infinite number of terms are there, infinite constant. Final, last one is like that. So this is the linear combination of these set of mutually orthogonal functions, which is nothing but trigonometric Fourier series representation of x of t. Trigonometric Fourier series representation of my signal x of t. So this signal x of t can be approximated. Actually, this is approximation, not exact representation, right? So if I write this compressed form, summation n equal to 1 to infinite an into cos n omega naught t plus one constant I have missed, a0. A naught I have written, n equal to 1 to infinite. Substitute n equal to 1, then a1 into cos omega naught t, this term, plus b1 into sine omega naught t, this term. Next, when n equal to 2, a2 into cos 2 omega naught t, plus b2 into sine 2 omega naught t. So n is varying from 1 to infinite. Okay. So infinite number of terms are there. In between, nth term is going to be there. Finally, infinite number of harmonic components. So this is the standard trigonometric Fourier series representation of x of t. Okay. Trigonometric Fourier series representation of x of t, any continuous time signal. Now here the calculation of coefficients is important. Calculation of TFS coefficients. So this calculation of coefficient, how to calculate C1, that formula we have seen already in the previous lectures, finding the constant using orthogonality concept and all. So here the formula for A0 is 1 by T0 integration of T0 to T0 plus T x of T into dt. These formulas you have to remember, because for the given signal x of t you have to find out a naught, substitute here. Next to TFS coefficient is an equal to 2 by t naught. See here, the fundamental frequency I am taking it as t naught. In some other textbook the representation is going to be like 2 by t, capital T only. Okay, whatever representation, it represents fundamental time period of the periodic signal. Integration t0 to t0 plus t, next x of t into an corresponding to cos terms. So cos n omega naught t dt, like that you have to remember. This is formula for a0, this is a formula for an. Similarly, now the formula for bn is 2 by t0 integration t0 plus t x of t, x of t into bn corresponding to sine terms. So sine n omega naught t into dt. Here bn is there. So sine n omega naught t I have to take. These are the formulas to calculate trigonometric Fourier series coefficients. So again some cases are there. If the signal is having even symmetry, then further simplifications are there for this TFS coefficients. Okay. So even symmetry. So these are the formulas. Evaluation of trigonometric Fourier series coefficients. A0 formula, An formula and Bn formula. Now the special case, if the signal x of t is having even symmetry, then how these formulas are going to be modified? That I am going to explain now. So even symmetry, if the signal x of t is having even symmetry means a naught equal to 1 by t naught, as t is whatever formula I have written, I wrote it once again here, t naught to t naught plus t naught capital t naught, or capital T you can write, whatever may be the fundamental period representation, x of t into t, this is the actual formula. If I take t naught as minus t naught by 2, means minus t naught by 2 to plus t naught by 2, this formula will become, isn't it? If I substitute t naught as minus t naught by 2, then upper limit t naught plus t naught will become plus t naught by 2, x of t into dt. Now from the standard formulas of integration, if x of t is an even function over the range minus a to a, or minus t naught by 2 to plus t naught by 2, this will become twice that of 0 to t naught by 2. From the standard integrations formula. So if the signal is having even symmetry means directly we have to take this formula. A naught equal to 2 by T naught integration half of this fundamental period into x of t dt. Means within this range whatever signal amplitude is there that I have to substitute and I have to solve the integration. Now similarly for AL, this is the standard formula I am having. 2 by T naught, T naught to T naught plus T naught, x of t into cos n omega naught t. Now let t naught equal to minus t naught by 2. So lower limit is minus t naught by 2, upper limit is plus t naught by 2. Now what is my assumption? Signal x of t is having even symmetry. So this is even function, cos is also an even function. Even into even, finally this total product is going to be an even function. So over the range minus t naught by 2 to t naught by 2, even term is there, total even function is there, that will become twice that of 2 into 2, 4 times 0 to t naught by 2, same function I have to write. So these are the formulas. Similarly, if I go for Bn, if the signal is having even symmetry. So if the signal is having even symmetry means here x of t is there, sin is there. X of t is even but sin is odd function. So if the signal is having even symmetry, this is a formula for An, this is a formula for An, this is a formula for A0, and what will be the formula for Bn? 0. From the standard properties of integration. What are the formulas I have taken here? Minus a to a f of x dx equal to 0. If this is odd function, or this is equal to 2 times of 0 to a f of x. If this is even function. Okay, from these relations only I have simplified all these. Similarly, next, if the signal is having odd symmetry. Okay, if the signal is having odd symmetry means, put the heading odd symmetry. The signal is having odd symmetry means a naught equal to, this formula I am taking, a naught equal to 1 by t naught minus t naught by 2 to plus t naught by 2. See here, this is range is totally one complete period, x of t into dt. So if this function is odd function, this is going to be 0 from this. Minus a to a f of x dx equal to 0 if f of x is odd function. Here x of t is odd function, so this a naught is going to be 0. Similarly, an is also, because an 2 by t naught minus t naught by 2 t naught, but x of t is odd function but cos is even. Odd into even will become totally odd function. So that is the reason an is also going to be 0. But whereas bn, bn x of t is odd function, sin is also odd function, odd into odd, like minus into minus, plus, odd into odd will become even function. So that is the reason here for Bn, the formula here is minus t naught, 0 to t naught by 2, it will become 0 to t naught by 2, x of t into sin n omega naught t into dt. So this is the formula for Bn. So if the signal is having even symmetry means a naught an terms will be present, bn terms are 0. Only cos terms will exist if the signal is having even symmetry. If the signal is having odd symmetry means trigonometric Fourier series contains only sine terms. Cosine terms are absent, zeros. A naught is zero, A n is zero. Only B n will exist if the signal is having odd symmetry. So similarly, if the signal is having even symmetry, means only cos terms will exist, sine terms will be absent. Means A naught and A n will exist, B n is zero. Okay.